back to the off-grid family. Today we're going to be doing another What's Inside video, and today we're going to be taking apart a couple of Hoovers. One of them doesn't work, and the other one you might as well use a straw and suck it up yourself, it's terrible. But I actually need two parts, well, a part out of each of them for an upcoming video, so I thought I might as well take them apart and show you what's inside at the same time. So let's get on. Okay, I have this little one here, which will be the first one I take apart. And I have then this big upright one. This one just doesn't work, and this one's the one that has about as much power as an old-fashioned Skoda. I've got a drill, electric screwdriver, some regular screwdrivers, and some wire cutters. I may need other things, I'm not sure yet. I haven't even bothered looking to see what I need. As with anything like this, start with the bits that should open. Nice. Okay. Do you know what? I owned this for about 5 years and I never noticed it had the suction bits on there. Handy. Now there's often screws hidden under labels, so always check the labels just to make sure, to see if there is anything. There isn't this time. Now what I'll do here is I'll speed it all up until I get to the fun bits, because a lot of this will be looking around trying to figure out what bits come off where and so on. First I'll get a pop for the screws. As always, I try not to waste anything, so if there's screws that I need, I will keep them. Now, there will be things in these that I don't know, that I'm not expecting, because they're, you know, they've got different functions to little bits. And I'll take them out, I'll have a look at them, and again, I will adjudicate whether I think I'll use them, and if I will, I'll keep them. If I won't, then I'll just get rid of them. But I try not to waste anything, as I'm sure you know if you've seen any of my other videos. Look at these one. I forgot to put the main light on, sorry guys. If you want to go to the effort of it, in places like this you'll see springs. These are all clipped into place, so if you push down on all the clips they'll come out, and behind these there's obviously some springs. So I'm going to get them out because I do actually collect springs, because I quite often need them. Okay, now we're into the guts of the thing, and under here somewhere there's going to be a motor. This is the spool that has the wire on, and if I can keep that intact I might try and take that out, because that would be quite handy to have as a, like on my desk or something, to have a spool of wire. This is the on-off switch, looks a bit crusty but maybe fixable, maybe usable I mean. Whenever taking something apart, just go careful. Just take your time. And what I used to do when I was younger is I'd just start beating it to death, trying to get bits out that I wanted. And then I'd realise, you know, that's not how to get it out. You know, that is going to just break whatever you're trying to get. So just take your time. And hopefully it will just, you know, pop out after a while. Often, whenever I found that I couldn't get something out and I'd fight and fight with it for ages, I'd snap a huge piece off and I'd get it out, and then suddenly I'd notice a screw I hadn't seen before. So just take your time, have a look. There's always something hidden. Like that screw just there. Right, so we've actually got the spring side of things out. So which side was screwed in then? That it would have been that way, wouldn't it? Yeah. I can actually use that coil again. Now if we unscrew these. Which way? Oh, no, let's just not worry. Okay, this is clipped on. I'm going to leave those clips there. When they've got these spade connectors, they can actually be really hard to get out. Sometimes near impossible, sometimes just need a bit of brute force. So that's a bonus, because I didn't think I was going to be able to get that out. A lot of times, these things are sat inside and then they've got been plastic formed in there. So you actually end up having to break most of it to get it out, but that is actually still all absolutely fine. Bonus. Okay, so out of this one, we got a motor, which I need to do a bit more unscrewing to get actually into, but I'm not sure if I'm going to bother with that, I'm not sure yet, because I'm doing a video on motors soon, you see, so that's what I actually wanted. So we've got the motor, we've got the coil with the switch still attached, so that could be used for something quite nice, and then we got one or two other bits, you know, a couple of springs, something that I might find quite useful. I'll come towards the camera. I got this thing here, which I might actually be able to use in one of my belt drives to actually hold the belt onto the wheel and give it tension. So if you have a look, but it is quite stiff. We'll have to see. It's something that I didn't have to pay for, so it's great. Okay. Look at all that dust on the table. If there was only some type of invention that would suck that up for me. Oh well, on to the next Hoover. Right, with these big upright hoovers, they often start, you know, being able to take them apart from right underneath them. There's often screws all around there, so that's where I'll start on this one. Now, there's two screws on each of these, and you can see that doesn't take all of it off or anything, but just start with any screws you can see. Doesn't matter, you're not trying to fix it. If you are trying to fix it, then take a little bit more of a delicate approach. Every now and again you need a torch. If you want to know how this torch was made, I'll put a little thingy up in the corner now. Oh, now I'm blown. Something I've forgotten to do is sometimes once you let the back down, as if you're hoovering, it releases some more screws, like you can see more screws, but I'm just gonna check once more around here. Make sure this one's gonna come out completely. I think that might be enough, but let's... This is one thing I always forget. Take this off first, because that is just like friction fit, and then the whole thing should come off. Remember the first time I fixed our Hoover at home, I knew that it was something simple, well, I assumed it was. And this thing, maybe this one isn't friction fit on. The other one was friction fit on, and I was trying to get this off, and I was pulling on it, I was doing all sorts of stuff. And in the end it just like popped off, and then it just came off easily. But I felt like a bit of a div, because I've been trying for ages. Now. I'm a bit stuck now, you know, I can't find where the rest of the screws are. So what you need to do, get your screwdriver in, and plonk it in and see where it's still getting held. So it's getting held still along here, because that's where the gap is opening up to, but I think that's probably just where it's been clipped in. So this bit's all coming up, and it's definitely getting stuck in the middle, so there's the problem. Just one huge screw that I'd missed. Thing is, even if you look for them as much as possible, you still end up missing them. It's inevitable. So now, there you go. Okay, one part of it off, and again, a little spring for the button, which I'm going to take off. Later, can't be bothered. This one used to always cut out. It was given to us broken, and I fixed it lots and lots and lots of times, but what would happen is this here just gets packed with nasties. You can actually remove the pipe at the back and just start taking it out that way. But it would just get so clogged up so quickly. It's such a bad design. It would just, I don't know, it just didn't like to travel the dust around the corner. But you'll see what I mean when I say clogged up. You just keep digging this stuff out. And there's loads and loads more of it, but that's where I'll leave that. I just don't want it flinging out in my face. Okay, now this is a relatively new belt, which I put on only about 3-4 months ago. When I put that on, I found the blockage, emptied that, and it still kept having problems. And it was because the belt kept slipping off, that there's nothing here to hold it on. Whether that was the problem or not, I don't know, but then it started to fill up with all sorts of nasties again, and it just clogs constantly, and then it overheats and turns itself off, which is a good thing, because I've had one blow up on me, well, set fire. I'd much rather them just stop working than actually set fire. I had to throw it out of an upstairs window, which was an interesting thing. The neighbours already think I'm mental, for good reason. Alright. We'll get that belt off in a minute. Now, I never throw any types of belts like this away. I'm always trying to make things like wind turbines and different little vehicles, that kind of thing. So these things come in handy. Okay, now I've done what I want around this little bit. And I'm checking up around the sides now, because you'll start finding other screws have appeared that weren't there before. Okay, now we've got it in 2 halves, we need to get this off because that's all I want from this. Take that as well. Do I want oils? No, is the answer. Right. There we go. Okay, so back to this now. Again, start looking around it, just make sure there's no screws that have appeared that you didn't see before because they were being covered, and here we go. Straight away, another one. That was a little one, wasn't it? It's like a blinking fence screw. When you take one out, have a look directly opposite, see if there's another one, because they often are quite symmetrical with things like that. In this case, they're not, but... Again, I'm just pulling it away slightly just to see where there's still things holding it. So, as you see, as I'm pulling it apart, there's less here that's come down here. And there's definitely something blocking it here, but I can't actually feel a screw in there. Right, don't check it again. I'm almost sure I'm taking all the screws out. Let's take this out. Okay, so there's a screw coming down this way. So we'll come back up to here then, and we'll start trying to remove bits from here. So, first off, figure out how the dust collection bit comes off. I'm going to keep this because I'm going to be making a specific project not very soon, but in the future, and it will need something like that, but I won't tell you any more yet.
looks really nice. More fun than the last one.
Seriously, this is still absolutely clogged to the top, man. It's like there was a U-bend in it and it was just tiny. So every little thing would get caught up in it. This comes in here, corner up, and it's just a mass of debris. That stuff I found in here, you could blink in insulate a house. Okay. Still clogged up in there. I see. Right, this one is one of those like security screws where it's only got two little divots to let you get it out. So I'm going to avoid it. I'm going to cut around it. Now when shoving your screwdriver into things, obviously, just be careful. Things can fly off at you if it's been turned on recently. There could be capacitors in it, all sorts, you know? So just be careful. Okay, and again, pretty similar to the last one. Probably almost the same type of motor. Let's get it out, shall we? Now when unscrewing the motor, just go careful because there's like screws that you can now see that are on the top and everything, which is all fine and good, except they hold the actual connectors to the brush and the rotor. Now this one's got a light in it as well, and that's all part of this, so I'll get it all out at the same time. If that's possible. And that is probably the U-bend of doom in there. It literally, it's terrible. Right. Yeah. and that is literally where the blockage starts. So this thing here, where it causes the suction, it just hits almost a brick wall and then doesn't go any further. An amazingly stupid design. Right. Okay, and another motor. Okay, as you can see, we've got quite a bit of salvage from all of that. We've got the two motors, which was after most of all, because I'm doing an upcoming motor project, as I said. We've got a telescopic tube. I'm not sure if I'll use that, but that's something that I can just put away. If I don't use it, get scrap it. I got some quite long cable, and I've got the telescopic, like the reelable inable one. I'm sure that makes sense in some language. Got a variety of springs, a 24 volt lamp, various switches and screws and so on, and this plastic container, which I will show you what that's for, but when I get around to doing it. So I turned something that was huge and a waste of space into something relatively compact, which can be stored a lot easier now. But all of these things that you see on the desk, well, on the table, will be used in various projects. I've taken a few days off, not because I've wanted to, but because I've been doing projects that last a long period of time, so it seems like I haven't put any videos up, but it's not out of not wanting to, it's just they're all still going. So there should be a flurry of new videos coming in the near future. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you liked it, subscribe and thumbs up, all that jazz. If you've got any questions, leave them in the comment section. Thanks for watching, see you again soon. Bye.